Welcome to a couple of bunkies.
Around July, Monport Laser sent us a laser engraver. If you're interested in purchasing the laser engraver we have, go ahead and use the link in the description below and use Timothy6 at checkout. We've been using our laser engraver for quite a bit. The laser engraver worked wonderfully, but I noticed after doing some repeated cuts that there were some inconsistencies on the power level. We felt that this had something to do with the temperature. After the laser would warm up, we would get temperatures in excess of 30 degrees Celsius. That would be around 90 Fahrenheit. Now, according to this K40 laser cutter and engraver site, it says one of the top reasons that your laser tube dies is due to over temp. The laser tube works best at 15 to 20 C. Anything above will degrade your tube. So we were reaching 30 C and that was degrading our tube. If you run at 23 C, it will not die tomorrow, but it will lower the life expectancy of the time by weeks and months. 20 Celsius is around 68 degrees Fahrenheit. So keeping the water temperature around room temperature is ideal. The cooling system we had set up was basically a small pump that we put in a big red bucket. We considered purchasing a chiller, but we weren't sure it would come in handy for our small setup. My wife and I decided to reach out to Monport Laser to see if they had any suggestions. We were shocked when they responded, saying that they would send us a chiller in about a week or so. We were both very happy with this and knew that we had to do a side-by-side comparison to show the differences between these two methods.
And here is our laser engraving workstation. We also have our cooling systems on the second tier of this workbench.
We had the bucket and pump set close together so we can change it easily.
We ran the laser engraver using our bucket cooling system first, and then we ran it with the chiller. We did allow some time to have the laser engraver cool down, but it didn't cool down all the way.
The water temperature while using the chiller was at 27.5 starting off. The chiller maintained the water temperature in the unit at 25 C.
There are just some fundamental differences between an open cooling system and a closed cooling system. In open cooling system, you have your environment affecting the cooling performance. With the bucket cooling, we were losing a lot of water due to evaporation.
The loss of water in an open system is very dangerous due to us not having a low-level alarm. We could run out of water and not know it and have the laser burn up.
Our Monport chiller system has a low water level alarm that alerts us when the water level drops below acceptable level. There is also less chance of losing water volume due to evaporation or any other environmental effect.
The alarm will also go off for low flow or high and low temperature. In both of these runs, it cut through the material the first time, and they both looked very much identical. The only difference was that with the chiller, it maintained the temperature throughout the entire process, while the bucket ended up raising its temperature. We are really happy that we got to do this experiment. We've had this chiller for a little over a month now, and seen significant improvement over the quality of cuts that we've done on longer projects.
I hope you liked this video. Please consider subscribing. And if you wish to get notified on our future videos, please ring that bell icon. Thank you for watching.
You can also send us a super thanks or buy us a coffee at buymeacoffee.com.